O people of the book, la taghlu fi dinikum. That's how Allah talks. My Allah doesn't talk like that. Says, Qul, say, Ya Ahl al-Kitab, la taghlu fi dinikum. Don't go to extremes in your religion.
Baby, you can call me a superman.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel.
It's your boy Jesse Keegan.
And your girl Fanny Lungu.
We are Fanny and Jesse. So right about now, we're going to do another reaction. Before we get into the reaction, guys, we want to thank everybody who's been subscribing to our channel. He's the Reader's MVP. And fun fact, I've been reading the Quran and I realized that in each and every surah, it starts with Bismillah, which is in the name of God or something like that. Yeah. And I mean, it's so, I didn't know that. Like every surah starts with Bismillah, which is really incredible anyway.
Fun fact.
Yeah, that's a fun fact anyway. So, right about now, we're going to do another reaction. Before we get into the reaction, first of all, we want to thank the people who've been giving us reaction videos. You're the Reader's MVP. And also, we want to thank the people who've been very, very, spot on commenting and stuff like that. You're also the Reader's MVP. And also, if you want to see our videos, we have our new channel, which goes by the name Fanny and Jesse 2.0. If you want to see our life, apart from doing reactions and stuff, just go and click the link below and just subscribe. Make sure to just go and watch all our videos.
Or just search Fanny and Jesse 2.0.
Yeah, just go and search. Yeah. That's the easiest way anyway. And yeah, so right about now, we're going to do another reaction video. And this one already was suggested by a lot of people. This suggested that we should go react to The Dad at His Best Part 7. So without any further ado, guys, let's get it.
The Prophet, peace be upon him, never addressed other religions in an aggressive nature as you do. Do you think your approach to spread and understand Islam is better, or the Prophet's amicable and courteous nature to others, other faiths? Right. Now, our sister, she has a right. She has a right to have her opinion, to say that I am in aggressive nature as you do. I don't know when you speak the truth. It does sound militant. It might sound offensive. And we are told in the Holy Quran that our Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the best example. Allah says, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنٌ. So most certainly in the Apostle of Allah, you have the best example. We accept. Can you differ with that? Allah is testifying that in the Prophet of Allah, you have the best example. But do you know that the mushriks of Makkah took offense against his preaching? Do you know that? Do you know his own people, they loved him. Before he made his pronouncement about Allah's wahdaniyat, Allah, they gave him a title, As-Sadiq al-Wa'dul Amin. As mushriks, they gave this title to our Nabi, that he is a Sadiq al-Wa'd, a person who is true to his word, is al-Amin, he is the truthful, the sincere, the faithful. This is what they called him. As soon as he opened his mouth about Allah's wahdaniyat, they wanted to kill him. It sounded offensive. This one is aggressive. He sounded militant. Look, the best of mankind, the best example, is creating offense. Maybe he didn't know how to talk. Maybe you know how to talk. Our alims know how to talk with hikmah. He didn't know hikmah. If you were there, would you have told him, Ya Rasulullah, you know Allah says in Surah An-Nahl, chapter 16, verse 125, Udu ila sabili rabbika bi hikmati. Invite all to the ways of the Lord with wisdom, meaning that he doesn't know wisdom. I want to know whether you would have told him that. That you sound aggressive. Look, these people are getting irritated. They want to kill you. You have to flee for your life. All the Sahabas had to make two migrations to Abyssinia. Why? Because they didn't know how to talk. Then he goes to Medina, and in Medina he starts with the Jews. You know, there's still Badr is still waiting, and Uhud is still waiting, and Khandaq is still waiting. Huh? They won't let him go. And now he starts with the Jews. If you were the Sahaba, his companion, would you have told him, Ya Rasulullah, look man, we have saved ourselves by the skin of our teeth, we have been saved, we have come around alive here. And now you're starting with the Jews. You know, use some wisdom, man. You know, why are you provoking people and the Jews and the Munafiqs, four different groups of people, all wanting to kill this man of God? You know why? Because he didn't know how to talk. Huh? Is that what it is? Maybe he sounded aggressive. And the message of Islam is militant. Do you know that? Allah says, Ya Ahl al-Kitab, O people of the book, La taghlu fi dinikum. That's how Allah talks. My Allah doesn't talk like that. He says, Qul, say, Ya Ahl al-Kitab, La taghlu fi dinikum. Don't go to extremes in your religion. وَلَا تَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْحَقِّ. And don't say anything about Allah except the truth. إِنَّمَا الْمَسِيحِ مُوسَى بِنُ مَسَيَحِ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ Jesus the son of Mary, Rasulullah, is the messenger of Allah. وَكَلِمَتُهُ And a word proceeding from him, أَلْقَهَا إِلَى مَرْيَمَ وَرُوحٌ مِّنْهُمْ Which he bestowed upon Mary, and a spirit proceeding from him, فَآمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ So believe in Allah and his messenger. This is how Allah talks. So, وَلَا تَكُونُوا سَلَاسَا وَلَا تَكُونُوا سَلَاسَا إِنَّ الْخَيْرَ لَكُمْ That's not my Allah, that's not my Rasul. I don't know what ideas you have about Rasulullah, how he did he do the job. I don't know what. No. He said, وَلَا تَكُونُوا سَلَاسَا When you tell somebody, hey, don't say Trinity. How do you don't say Trinity? You know? Stop it. Stop it. Well, maybe. You see, your husband's happy and your father's got that chicken voice, I don't know. Look, Allah has made me a lion. I'm not acting. I'm telling you, I'm not acting. This is what Allah has given to me. As the chairman said, I'm 77 years old, 78. Look at this. No. Your grandfather, 77 years old, he can never do that. Do you know that? Huh? He can never talk like this. Do you know that? Then what are you blaming me? If I sound militant, I am militant. This is, Islam expects each and every Muslim to be militant. So, وَلَا تَقُولُوا سَلَاسَا Don't say Trinity. إِنْتَهُ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ This is, stop it, it will be better for you. إِنَّمَا اللَّهُ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ For you, Allah is one of Allah. It's not three in one. Allah says, لَكَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهُ مَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ Whoever says that Jesus Christ, the son of Mary, is God, is making kufr. He says, he's making kufr. I say he's making kufr. It's an act of blasphemy, treason against Allah. وَقَالَ الْمَسِيحِ But Masih said, Ya Bani Israel, O children of Israel, لَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ Worship Allah. رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ Who is my Lord and your Lord. إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ Whoever will associate anyone with Allah, فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ لِي الْجَنَّةِ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ لِي الْجَنَّةِ Allah will forbid him paradise. وَمَأْوَاهُ النَّارِ And the fire of hell will be their dwelling place. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارٍ And for the wrongdoers there will be no one to help. This is how Allah talks. If you listen to him, this is how he talks. And if I try to reproduce his militancy, you say, I sound aggressive. I don't know, my sister. You have a billion Muslims in the world who can bleat like goats. That's the choice. You can bleat and talk. I just can't do that. I don't know. I myself, I'm Muhammad Didat. That's what it is. If you like me, okay. If you don't like me, pray for me.
My question is, in the light of what the Bible mentions about the conversation between God and Adam in Jannah, when God asks questions and then gets answers from Adam, how can we interpret some ayahs and hadith of Prophet, especially hadith Qudsi, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks, for example, وَإِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخِذُونِي وَأُمِّيَ إِلَهَيْنِ etc. And then some hadith where Allah asked Jibreel, who are those people and what are they doing in the mosque? And these questions. Allah, as we know, better knows these things. But I think there's an interpretation for these ayahs. JazakAllah.
You see, in the Holy Quran, we are told that on the day of judgment, Allah will ask Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, Go Isa. Did you tell your followers to worship you and your mother besides Allah? He says, Ya Bari Ta'ala, You know I never did any such thing. If I had done it, you would have known it. And as long as I was with them, I was a witness over them to see that they didn't blaspheme, didn't do kufar. But after you took me up, you know what they did. So, إِن تُعَذِّبْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُكَ وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. So, if you forgive them, they are your servants. They are your property, you can do what you like with them. Or if you punish them, they are your servants. They are your property, you can do what you like with them. وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. But if you forgive them, you are exalted in might, you are wise. This is your prerogative, you can do what you like. Now, what is it now? Is it now with Allah speak? Yes, He will speak, but not this. Allah is telling us in the Quran what He is. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. Not only nothing like Him, but nothing is the likeness of Him that you can imagine. He hasn't got a mouth with lips and with teeth and tongue and larynx and lung. This is your concept of God. God is not like that. He is beyond the imagination of the mind of man. We know He exists, we know He is real, but He is not like the way they portray about Him. That this God is like this, and He hungers and thirsts and He runs. Somebody wants to kill Him and He goes and hides away. Jesus. So God that is running away from the Jews? No, this is, we say, it is not the right concept. Yes,
sir. He doesn't know that you've been reading the Bible, is that right?
Wow.
What do you think?
Such a nice message or video. What I got from the dad towards the end when he talked about it's not what you think about God. Like probably people think like God looks like let's say like us, but in a bigger manner or something like that. But what he said is that
like
Zeus. Yes, like something huge. You get it. But what he said is like is something that is beyond human comprehension or human thinking. You get it? It's something that it doesn't have eyes, it doesn't have mouth, it doesn't have hands and whatnot. Something just unseen. You get it? Which brings me to a video that we were reacting to about Sangro when he mentioned that God is everywhere. No. He said that if we humans say that God is
like us.
Yes, looks like us. Also, the buffalo will also think that God is a bigger buffalo. You understand? So, which it defeats the purpose of actually thinking that God looks like us or whatever. I mean, what did that say over here is it's just like really amazing. It's something beyond our comprehension, like it's something beyond us. We cannot even imagine. God is just, you can't see God, but He's here with you. You get it? He's just everywhere. But you can't touch, you can't see, like he doesn't have mouth, eyes, just like what he said. I mean, such a nice video. What do you think?
I like the question in the beginning. Mm-hmm. You don't want to touch on us before I speak?
No.
Or him being aggressive?
I think being aggressive is one thing that defines you. You get it? Because if you have some leadership skills, at some point you have to be an aggressive person. You understand? And what you also touched about is the God that he praises is an aggressive God, yeah? You get it? Like not God that will talk in a very low voice or something like that. It's a God that He will be aggressive and try to, you know, put the territory and stuff like that. You get it? I mean.
But then this is the thing. How do you know the God you praise is aggressive? Aggression is one thing, but then sometimes when you're too aggressive, people don't want to listen to you. not because you're saying the wrong things,
yeah, I mean,
but
don't,
because of your tone.
Yeah, don't overdo it. I mean, being aggressive is okay. You have to look
at... okay.
Being aggressive is not bad.
That's why he said maybe he doesn't know how to talk. Some of these things, the way, sometimes we mimic the way our parents talk.
Mm-hmm.
So if I'm aggressive towards you, maybe I learned or got that behavior from someone in my family.
Mm-hmm.
Anything can be taught in life. You can be taught how to speak nicely, just like we are taught how to use fork and knife. Just like we are taught to dress for certain occasions. But then aggression sometimes is just not it. It just doesn't cut it. Another thing is, how do you know that God is aggressive? Because if you think about it, what everyone is basing, not everyone, but he gave reference to the God he says. He hasn't heard him talk, has he? Yeah, we're just reading texts, and from those texts we're saying, okay, he's aggressive, he's not aggressive, here he was fine, here he was calm, here he was being too kind. Anything written will forever be misleading. That's why people say, when you say, sometimes sending a message will get you into trouble. So you better call, because the other person on the other end will miss and misinterpret what you're trying to say. They may get the wrong vibe.
For me, according to me, aggressiveness is not bad, but know where to pick it up. Anyway, guys, if you feel like we've reacted to this video in a better way, give us a thumbs up, and don't forget to go down our comment section below and tell us exactly what you feel about our reaction, what you feel about the video we just reacted about. Ahmed did that at his best, part 7. Just let us know in the comment section below what you think. And also, the most important thing, guys, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The more you keep on subscribing, the more you give us the motivation to do a lot of videos and to give you better content. And last but not the least, we're going to see the next video. And peace out.